Om Shanti. We all remember our beloved Supreme Father God with different names, but we all have forgotten His true identity. Therefore, our Supreme God Father has descended on this physical world in the body of an ordinary man at the end period of Iron Age and has given us His own introduction that, "My sweet children, my name is Shiv. I am point of light. I don't have my own body. I am incorporeal and beyond time. I am free from cycle of birth and death. I am the seed of mankind. I am the resident of soul world and ocean of knowledge, peace, love and bliss. You, my sweet children, are also immortal point of light called soul. The body is your costume only. It's a statue of flesh and bones, which you are changing from time to time. Body is declared dead when soul leaves the body. Soul has three faculties: mind, which thinks; intellect, which takes decisions; sanskar, whatever good or bad deeds we do become our sanskar. The soul seated at the center of forehead and governs the functioning of whole body. The Supreme Father Shiv has unfolded the secret of three worlds to us. First is physical world, where we soul take up body of five elements and play our part in world drama. This is also called the karmic place. Here we experience happiness and sadness as per our good and bad deeds. Second is subtle world, which far away, beyond the sun, moon and stars, where subtle deities Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar resides. Here body of bone and flesh does not exist, but the body of light exists. In this world, the language for communication is thought. Third is incorporeal world, which beyond subtle world, it is also called Param Dham, Nirvan Dham, Brahm Lok, Mukti Dham. It is residence of souls. We souls reside here with Supreme Soul Shiv in our original form of point of light. This world is full of self-luminous golden red light. The Supreme Father of we all souls is one incorporeal God Shiv. The people of all religion also believe that God is one and He is our Father. People of all religion worship the Supreme Father Shiv in different forms. In India also, almost at all places we find Shiv temple. At Makkah, the main holy place of Muslim brothers, there is a big stone like sibling which is worshipped by them with high respect. They call it as Sange Asmad. In Japan, the disciple of Buddha also do meditation by keeping a red stone like sibling before them. The founder of Christian religion, Jesus Christ, and Guru Nanak of Sikh religion have always believed that God is one and is a point of light. Moreover, they have always believed themselves as child of God. At the end of Kalpa, the three deities are created by Supreme Soul Shiv. At the end period of Iron Age, Supreme Soul Shiv descend in the body of an ordinary man and Shiv named him as Prajapita Brahma. Shiv undertaken all the activities to create new divine world, heaven, through Prajapita Brahma. The new world is taken care by Vishnu and destruction of old hellism world is done by Shankar. Many people believe that Shiv and Shankar are same, but there is a great difference in them. We praise Shiv as Shiv Paramatma Namah, and therefore Shiv is God. Shiv resides in the Param Dham called Soul World. He is benevolent of all souls. His form is incorporeal, point of light, whereas Shankar is prayed as Shankar Devtai Namaha, that is as deity. He resides in the subtle world. His duty is to destroy old hellism world. He has a body. Shankar is always found in meditation posture and Shivling is before him. He is creation of God Shiva. Supreme Father Shiva has unfolded many vital points of knowledge to us. He has made it clear that human soul never takes birth as bird and animals. Human soul takes birth as human beings only, either as a man or woman, because there is a vast difference of mind and intellectual power of human and animal soul. Just like a mango tree grow from the mango seed and banana tree grow from the banana seed only, can't be other tree. In the same way, human soul takes birth as human beings only. The world drama is wonderful and eternal game of nature and human beings. This world drama is getting repeated as it is after every 5,000 years. Each soul at his particular time descend from soul world Paramdham to the earth to play his eternal part and passes through three stages, Sato, Rajo and Tamo. At the ending period of Iron Age, when drama is reaches to almost its end stage and all souls are highly influenced by the vices. At this stage, the creator and director of this world drama, the Supreme Father God Shiva himself, descend on the earth in the body of Prajapita Brahma and meets the human souls as their father and mother. The Supreme Father Shiva descend only once in four yugas at the end of Iron Age, which is called Confluence Age. In this period, Supreme Father Shiva gives birthright to their children of salvation and heavenly sovereignty. Also, re-establish the Golden Age and destruct the old hellism world. To attain our complete stage of actualization, to be free from vices, to have peaceful, prosperous and happy life, one has to have continuous practice of Raj Yoga. Raj Yoga is a simple form of yoga. Raj Yoga means to detach from body consciousness of the self and to be stable with our true identity as point of light soul, and to remember our beloved Supreme Father Shiva in the same form of point of light with love. For the practice and deep experience of Raj Yoga, we need to follow some rules. As the aim of Raj Yoga is to purify the mind and intellect and transform our attitude. For this, it is very much essential that we follow four basic principles. These four pillars are the foundation for the higher stage of Raj Yoga. First is celibacy. Second is pure food. Third is spiritual class. Fourth is divine virtues. With the practice of Raj Yoga, that is by connecting our mind with Supreme Father Shiva, we got eternal prosperity, peace, love and bliss. Not only this, but we wipe out fruits of our bad deeds or sins which we committed in the past birth as well as in present birth. Moreover, we are empowered with many spiritual powers, and with such powers our life becomes completely balanced. We also become free from our all internal weaknesses. Om Shanti.